Good evening, dear students. Let us cover some very important of the Laplace transform, important aspect of the Laplace transform, which concerns with one-sided Laplace transform. So, to revise your memory, we have defined two-sided Laplace transform by this expression. This is two-sided Laplace transform. Here, signal xt may exist in the entire time domain. That means the range of t is this. Now let's see what about unilateral Laplace transform. Which has been defined only for positive time domain, and let us rewrite its definition. Now here, Laplace transform of any signal xt is taken in this interval. That means signal exists only in this time domain. T 0 minus indicates any initial condition regarding the signal xt. That means here the range of t is from 0 minus to infinity. Now, there is a difference between these two. In this case, if I shift the signal xt either to the right or to the left, the shifting property gets totally modified. It is not like two-sided Z transform. Let us cover that aspect with an example. Let us consider this signal xt, which is something like this, and say this is minus 2 and this is some 3, a time axis. Now, if I take this unilateral Laplace transform, then you know, in positive time domain, signal exists from 0 to 3 only. So, only this portion of the signal xt will contribute to the one-sided Laplace transform. And that will be denoting as x of s. Now, the picture becomes totally different in this case as compared to the two-sided Laplace transform. If I apply shift property to the signal xt. Suppose I shift the signal, xt signal, by 1 unit to the right. Then let us mark some point minus 1 at time axis. Now I can get x of t minus 1 from xt provided I shift the signal 1 unit to the right. So let me mark this point as x to clarify the point. Now x t minus 1 will start some area. That means the portion of the signal which was in extreme from minus 1 to 0 goes in, enter into the positive time domain. Now, if I take initial delta transform of signal x of t minus 1, we have got a contribution of this portion over here. So, the one inside the Laplace transform of both will differ. It will not be same. And thereby, the shift property in case of two sided Laplace transform and one sided Laplace transform are different. So, let us, for any general arbitrary signal xt, let us try to find out the Laplace transform of say if one sided Laplace transform of signal xt is defined as x, unilateral Laplace transform or one sided Laplace transform are same. Unilateral Laplace transform. I am defining the unilateral Laplace transform of xt as x of s. Now, I write here ULT, unilateral Laplace transform. Now, I want to find out what is the Laplace transform of xt minus 1. So, from defining equation 0 minus to infinity x of t minus 1 e raised to the power minus st dt. This becomes this. Now, let us substitute for t minus 1. Let t minus 1 be tau. Then, if I differentiate t minus 1 with respect to tau to get dt. So, differentiation is one step, and then we have to find the limit of integration for the new variable tau. So, t is minus 0, tau becomes minus 1. So, this becomes tau of minus 1. Now, if t equal to 0, then tau, sorry, infinity, then infinity minus 1 is again infinity. This becomes infinite. And here, t minus 1 is tau. So, I replace t minus 1 by tau. Then, e raised to power minus 1, t becomes tau plus 1. Now, let us try to put this expression in terms of the defining equation. So, what do I get? The first term is, this is e raised to power minus s. So, I am taking e raised to power minus s out as a factor. So, I get e raised to power minus s and then minus of 1 to infinity x of tau e raised to power minus s tau d tau. Now, I again compare this with this. Here, the limit of integration starts at 0 minus and here it starts at minus of 1. So, I must decompose this integral into two integrals. So that one of them starts at 0 minus. So, d of s integral from 0 minus to 0 infinity, sorry, minus 1 to 0 minus x tau e raised to power minus s tau d tau plus 0 minus to infinity x tau e raised to power minus s tau d tau. Look what here I have done. This is the continuous line in time axis. Say t equal to 0 is somewhere here. Then minus 1 is here. And of course it goes to infinity. So I have decomposed this integral from minus 1 to 0 and then to 0 to infinity. That is what I have done over here. Now, this, if I compare this with the defining equation, then this becomes x of s. So what we get here is e raised power minus s minus 1 to 0 x tau e raised power minus s tau d tau plus x of s. Now you'll find something very remarkable. Since the signal xt has been shifted by 1 unit, you find the signal from portion minus 1 to 0 enters to the right side, positive time domain. And that is why this part has contributed to the Laplace transform of x of s. So, we can say that Laplace transform of this will be e raised power minus s, x of s plus minus 1 to 0, x tau, e raised power minus s tau, d tau. In fact, this contributes to the initial condition of the signal. This first portion of the signal from negative time domain has entered into the positive time domain as a result of this shifting, and that's why I have got this additional term. Now, let us see what happens otherwise. One-sided Laplace transform, unilateral Laplace transform of xt is defined as x of s. Then, what is one-sided Laplace transform of xt plus 1? Let us again have a signal representation, something like this. Say this is minus 2 to minus 3. This is 1 and this is 0. Now the signal xt plus 1, I will get xt plus 1 from xt provided I shift the signal 1 unit to the left. If I do that, then xt plus 1, say this first portion which is in positive time domain right now, if I shift it by this unit, then the portion which is marked between the two cross points will enter into the negative time domain. So this becomes the signal somewhat. This figure is not replicated because it's a blackboard, it's dying problem. So this is now 0 and this will become now minus 2 this 3. So this becomes 2. Now the one-sided Laplace transform of xt plus 1 will be obtained if I integrate between this two. So the contribution of this portion, which has entered into the negative time domain because of this shifting, is lost. So you will see that in this expression there is a minus term. You get two terms, one will be plus and the other will be minus. So now let's try to find out the unilateral transform of xt plus 1, which is from defining equation 0 minus 1 to infinity xt plus 1. E raised power minus st dt. Now let us substitute t plus 1 as tau. Put t plus 1 as tau, and if I differentiate, then I get dt as d tau. Now let's see what are the new limits for this new variable tau. So when t is 0, tau becomes 1, and when t is infinite, this again becomes tau becomes infinite, and xt plus 1 becomes x of tau, and it is from minus s, t becomes from here tau minus 1. So tau minus 1 d tau. Now the task is to represent this integral into one-sided Laplace transform, which exists from 0 minus. So let us take again the number line. Integral starts from 0, 1. Here it starts from 1. So that means I am integrating from 1 to infinity. So to make this integral, to start this integral from 0, let us add this portion, integration of this portion minus integration of this portion, these two terms. So this can be now written as integral 0 minus to infinity x tau e raised power minus s tau minus 1 d tau. I have added this portion. Now let us subtract this also. 0 minus 1, 1, x tau, e raised power minus s, t minus tau, d tau. Now, here the function should be e raised power minus s tau, e raised power s is extra. So, e raised power s I have taken out. Now I can say that this is 0 minus to infinity x tau, e raised power minus s tau, d tau, plus. Sorry, this minus e raised power 0 minus to 1 x tau e raised power minus s tau d tau. This we have defined as x of s. So what we get here is es x of s minus 0 minus to 1 x tau e raised power minus s tau d tau. Look, the contribution of this part, signal was shifted to left. So, a portion from 0 to 1 has gone to this side, and that's why it has lost its contribution from one side is at the, sorry, Laplace transform to this. And this minus sign indicates the loss of the contribution. So, now you can generalize this here. I have taken 1. In this case, x of t minus 1, this was the previous case, and the current case is this. You can generalize this here. If you can assume that the sum quantity p, q, or anything, you can generalize this here. Now, another is interesting real. One-sided Laplace transform of the signal xt is x of s, then what would be one-sided Laplace transform of a signal which is just the integral of xt? What would be unilateral Laplace transform of this? So this now let's try to find out what is the unilateral Laplace transform of this. Let's take unilateral Laplace transform of both sides. Let's do the same job over here. Then now, hereafter, the whole effort is how to integrate this integral. Now, let us decompose this signal into two parts. One which belongs to the negative time domain and other part which belongs to positive time domain. So, I can write this as minus infinity to 0, negative part x tau d tau e raised to power minus st dt, and the other part from 0 to t x tau d tau e raised to power minus st dt. Look here, this integral has been decomposed into two integrals. One integral where the tau belongs to the negative time domain, and the other integral where tau belongs to positive time domain. T is supposed to be greater than 0. Now let us try to evaluate this integral. So if I just try to find out what is the Laplace transform of this, then we can take this integral as integration by parts. Let us take this as first part and this as second part. So first part into integral of this. This becomes this is the first part into integral of second part, which becomes e of minus st by minus s, and the integration limits becomes 0 minus to infinity. Then minus second part into differential of first. So this becomes first function into integral of this. Then the differential coefficient of the first function. This becomes 0 minus infinity. Differential of this becomes x tau, or say